Because of being efficient is when you think about your allocation efficiency and productive efficiency. So if you have good, then you can talk about economic efficiency. But this is all about big firms. Now we go into what we call cost-benefit analysis. Why do we really need cost-benefit analysis? We need cost-benefit analysis to be able to make decisions regarding our projects. So cost-benefit analysis are made so as decisions of the future projects can be made. Is that point clear? Okay, so look at what I do here. Use of cost-benefit analysis and decision making. It is a method of taking into account the cost and benefit of a project. So you are taking into account the cost and benefit. The cost is going to, the amount you're going to spend on making this project done. And who are those who are going to enjoy this project having been done? That is taking account into what? Taking into account the cost and benefit of a particular project. Is that clear? So cost-benefit analysis is used by the public sector in case of providing public goods, such as a road or a rail project. Cost-benefit analysis we use in the public sector. What is the public sector? A sector that is controlled by the government. So they use cost-benefit analysis to take decisions about whatever project they want to do. So we talk about a road and rail project. A road and rail project is a long-term project. It's not a project like just making a chair or a table. It's a project that will take over 5 years, over 6 years to be done. So it's a long view project. So when you have to put a lot of finance into such projects, you need to do what we call a cost-benefit analysis. One of the reasons why you have to do a cost-benefit analysis is to check about the opportunity cost. So maybe at this point in time, we shouldn't spend so much of money, we shouldn't spend so much of time making up this road, making up this rail. Maybe we have to quickly spend some time, quickly invest or quickly put some funds into our school or educational projects, not road, not rail. Maybe we have to build up our airports, not road, not rail. So these are reasons why we have to take up into what? Cost analysis, cost-benefit analysis. So we should be able to know, as government, they will be able, because they don't have a lot of money, the revenue they make is from taxation. So it should be spent judiciously. So when you have to spend judiciously, you have to think, you have to make decisions. Analyzing what will be the cost and what will be the benefits. Is that clear?
Yes.
So, the public goods such as road and rail projects, in this case, no particular charges are directed to the users. So it is important to take decisions regarding it if the project should be progressed. Because this money that you're going to use in building this road, the money you're going to use in building that rail, is not going to be gotten from individuals or consumers. I mean, the users of the road, the users of the rail, nobody's going to pay you directly. They might pay indirectly through tax, but you won't get money from them directly to say, oh, we are building a road for a street, or we are building a road for this state. You have to pay a certain amount of money. You don't do that. So it is not directly involved by the users. So you don't get financed directly from the users. So because of this reason, the revenue you have to use needs to be analyzed. The amount of money you have to spend, the expenditures, they need to be analyzed. That's when you talk about cost, government expenditure. So it is a public finance. So if a public finance, what do we call public finance? Public finance is it's the amount of the cost at which government spends on projects like this. So when you have to spend such amount on projects like this, you have to analyze. You have to check, you have to balance it up to check what the costs are and what the benefits are. However, the decision will be checking the balance between the social cost and social benefits of such projects. Social cost and social benefits. Okay, of such projects. So when you make a cost-benefit analysis, that's CBA, it means you are checking the social cost. What's the social cost? The sum of your external cost and your private cost. The cost for the whole society, that's the social cost. And benefits, social benefits, what? The benefit for the whole society, that's the sum of what? The private benefit and the external benefits. So here, you have to make analysis on Here you have to make analysis on what your external benefits and your private benefits. So external benefit plus private benefit will give you what? Social benefits. Then external cost plus private cost will give you what? Social cost. Is that fair?
Can you just raise the board in the right side and write this equation for me?
Okay, I'll do that. So this one will be checking on the balance between social cost and social benefit of social projects. This process is called cost-benefit analysis. So cost-benefit analysis simply means what? We are weighing the balance between your social cost and your social benefits. And what is social cost? I said again, social cost is your external cost plus your private cost. And social benefit is what? Your external benefits plus your private benefits. What are private benefits? The benefits that are directly to you because you have provided a good or a service. The benefit you enjoy for providing a good or service is a private benefit. The benefit that third parties enjoy because of your own action is what we call external benefit. Same goes to cost. External costs are costs that are incurred by the third parties. Why? Private costs are the costs that you incur because you provide a good or service. So the combination is social cost and social benefits. So though the private sectors also take into consideration the CBA, this is the cost-benefit analysis, but it differs from the public sector, as the public sector takes into consideration the following. So not only the public sector that uses CBA, even the private sector, they use it. But what makes the CBA of the private sector differs from the CBA of the public sector? These are the reasons. One, in the CBA of the public sector, all the social costs and benefits included the private ones. So the CBA of the CBA of the public sector includes even the private costs and private benefits. So they think about the private sector. So public sector does not only think about the people, they also think about what? The private sector. So this is the difference between the CBA of the private sector and the CBA of the public sector. The CBA of the private sector does not need to put into account the public sector. While the CBA of the public sector must put into account the CBA, the private sector. So they don't only think about the society, they also think about the private firms. That's the difference between the CBA of the public sector and the CBA of the private sector. I'm going to repeat again. The CBA is what cost benefit analysis. What does it do? It weighs the difference between the social cost and the social benefits. So if it weighs the difference between the balancing or the difference between the social cost and social benefits, how does it differ from the private sector? How does the CBA of the private sector differs from the CBA of the public sector? The difference are this. One, the CBA of the public sector does take account into what the private sector. They think about the private sector. But you see, when the private sector needs to think about their own CBA, they don't put into account the public sector. The public sector is not their own concern. But the public sector, making its own CBA, must put into account the private sector. That's number one. Two, it often includes shadow price. Shadow price is the price that is given when there are no available market price. The public sector, unlike the private sector works with price. They have price for everything available, ready. But the public sector, they don't give a price, they give a shadow price. What is the shadow price? A price of, maybe the cost is going to be for 10. So let's say within 8 to 10. So they're not going to give a specific price, unlike the private sector. The private sector will give a specific price, but government do not give specific price. They give a shadow price. So they weigh maybe from 8 to 10, from 10 to 12, based on what? Their interpretation of the cost-benefit analysis. Is that fair? So what are the stages we take into CBA? Stages of the CBA. One, identification of all relevant costs and benefits. So when you have to take into account the cost-benefit analysis of a project, the first thing you have to think about is what are the costs we need to incur? What are the benefits we stand to enjoy? Look at what I'm going to say again. What are the benefits, what are the costs we need to incur? And what are the benefits we start or we tend to enjoy? That is what identification of all relevant costs and benefits. The cost you will incur, the benefits you stand to enjoy. Two, putting a monetary value on all costs and benefits. So now that we've known what the cost is, what the costs are, and what now that you know what the benefits are, how much are your costs? How much are your benefits? Now place an amount on it, a monetary value. Oh, the cost is going to be $20,000. Oh, the benefit is going to be worth $35,000.
What is the monetary value?
Put an amount of money into what you want to do.
Okay.
The third one, forecasting future costs and benefits. So how to make this project? What are the maintenance fees? So we're going to make a road now. We said forecasting future costs and benefits. We have to make a road now. So if we are making a road now, in the future, how much are you going to spend on it? Maintaining those roads. That is, you have to forecast the future cost. So the amount you have to spend maintaining the roads you want to make now. That is the forecast. The amount, numbers of people that will enjoy, that stand to enjoy this benefit when the road is made. Forecasting future benefits. Forecasting future costs means what? The amount of money you're going to spend maintaining this project. Forecasting future benefits. How many people, or how many generations stands to enjoy this project? That is forecast. Is it clear?
Yes.
And the last one, decision making which will be based on the interpretation of the CBA. So at the end of it all, if the social benefit is more than the social cost, we go on with the project. We progress with the project. That is, if our CBA analysis states that the social benefit is more than the social cost. If our CBA, the cost benefit analysis states that the social cost is $10,000, while the social benefit is more than $20,000, just an example. So then we can go on with what? The project. So that is, these are the stages at which we make our CBA. So the first one is you identify the cost and benefit. The next one is what? You place the monetary value on the cost and benefit. The third one, you forecast the future expenses and the future revenue on such projects. What's your maintenance will be, the cost of your maintenance in the future, and the benefits of the next generation. That is forecasting future costs and benefits. And the last one, then you make your analysis, you make your decision regarding what? If the project will progress or not. If the only way the project will be progressed is if the cost benefits are more than the cost.